Kevin, what are you doing?
Well, Richard was nice enough to email the other day, and he said, I learned something. He said, I was TIG welding, and I was trying to TIG weld on little, on 16 gauge, and he said, I was using 1/8 inch diameter filler rod. Oh my God. And he said, I just kept blowing holes. I just kept making one heck of a mess, and he couldn't figure out why. So he finally went from the 1/8 inch rod to 1/16 of an inch rod, and he said his welds got a whole lot better real quick. And he said he looked around and he couldn't find that anywhere. He couldn't find it on my channel. You know, nobody seemed to talk about, well, how do you pick the right diameter filler rod for the job that you're doing? And I thought, well, you know, that's a really good point. That's a good question. You know, that's a good topic that, you know, everybody, all us beginners should probably talk about at one point or another. So how do you pick the right filler rod? I like to use a bigger diameter rod depending on the amperage. So say above about 75, 80 amps up in that area, so let's say like 80 amps and above, I'm going to be using either a 3/32 or an 1/8 inch. The other part of that is it all depends on what kind of rod, what amperage you're using, but it also depends on how big of a fillet you want, how big of a weld you want. More metal, bigger weld. But you also have to balance that with the amperage. Less amperage for thinner base metal means you're going to have a harder time melting and flowing the larger diameter filler rods. Wow, a lot to think of all of a sudden. So let me put my helmet on. Let me fire up the AHP Alpha TIG over here, and I'm going to set up the amperage to weld this 16 gauge. Don't touch it, and just switch from the 1/8 inch to the 1/16 of an inch back again, just to show you the difference in just the size of the rod makes in what kind of weld you get. So 1/16 of an inch tungsten, 55 amps on the AHP Alpha TIG over there, and let's start out with the 1/8 inch. This is gonna be fun. And the first thing I notice right off the bat is how long it takes for that 1/8 inch rod to melt. So let's try the 1/16 of an inch, see how that works. That seems to work better. Well, yeah, Richard, you're absolutely correct, man. With the 1/8 inch filler rod down here, with the 55 amps set on the Alpha TIG, takes forever to get that filler rod to melt. And then you start having little problems where, you know, I can see it was starting to get a little hot. It was getting ready to blow through. Just because I'm sitting there for so long, you know, just trying to work back and forth and get that filler rod to melt, because it's such a huge chunk you're putting right there. And then come up here where the 1/16 of an inch. And yeah, sure, I preheated the metal a little bit from welding down here, but man, it went along a whole lot quicker. You're in one position for less time, because you're using a smaller filler rod, it melts quicker, so you can be moving along. You can be trying to stay ahead of that heat or keep up with that heat as you're moving along there, so you're not overheating where you are. So great tip, Richard, thank you. Select the correct size filler rod for not only what you're doing, not what you're welding, but also for the amperage that you're doing. So good eye, good thought. Thank you. And the rest of you guys, thank Richard also. So I'm gonna go back to doing what I was doing. And hopefully you guys are going to come out to my website and sign up for my newsletter and see what's going on in the work section, because there's always something going on. I'll see you guys next time.
So, Devin, when do I get to weld?